Here is the okay, now see here 25.5. See here, यहाँ पे color paint का box कितने का है 25 and 50 पैसे. So how we have written in the decimal point, that is 25.50, 25 rupees and 50 paise. It will return as like this, rupees paise. Okay. And our book is of 6.5. Half means same, 50 paise. Our eraser is of 1.5. And our pen is 4.5. So now we have to plus it. So how we will plus? See here, 0, 0, 0 plus 0, 5 plus 5, 10, 10 plus 5, 15. 15 plus 5, 20. So we will carry here 2 and we will write here 0. Okay. But after two numbers, there is a decimal point. After two numbers, there is a decimal point. So after two numbers, we will also write a decimal point. If there is a 2 after two numbers, there is a decimal point. So we also have to write the decimal point, and we have to convert the number according to the decimal point only. That I will explain you. Okay, then now see, after two numbers there is a decimal point, so we will take decimal point after two numbers only. Now 5 plus 6, wait, huh? Huh. 5 plus 6 equals to 11. 11 plus 1 equals to 12. And 12 plus 4 equals to 16. 16, but we have taken 2 carry here now of 20. So 16 plus 2 equals to 18. 16 plus 2 equals to 18. 18, it means 1 carry here and 8. Okay, now what is that? 2 plus 1, 3. So the total money of the instruments is, of the stationery, is 38.00. What is the total money? Humko kitna dena hai shopkeeper ko? 38.00. Okay. It means that is 38 rupees. We don't have to give any paise because it converted by plusing it. It has the, it came into rupees. Okay. Now see this question. If gave 100 rupees note, how much money we can get back? For example, if you have gone to the shop and you have taken this stationery, okay, and you got, and the shopkeeper has told, now you have to pay 38 rupees, okay. Now 38 rupees you have to pay, but you are having a 100 rupees note. You are having a 100 rupees decimal point, okay, 100 rupees note. So what you will do, you will, if you will give a 100 rupees note, so how many money the shopkeeper will give you back? So how you will come to, you know, we will minus 38 from 100. We will minus 38 from 100, and the common solve the sums in your book. If you will minus 100, 38 minus 100, so you will get 62.00. How, that also I will tell you. See, wait, huh? Minus decimal point below decimal point. Okay, after, you have to write decimal point ke niche hi aapko decimal point dena hai. 8, 3. Okay, 0, 0. So how you will get 0 minus 0, 0, 0 minus 0, 0. After that, one decimal point. 0 minus 8 we can't do, but we are having here 1. We will cut it, we will make it 0. 10, we will cut it, make it 9. And 10, 10 minus 8, 2. 9 minus 3, 6, and as it is 0. So before the number, if 0 is there, there is no value of the 0. If there is 0 after the number, if there is a value. But after the decimal point, there is a number of 0. It doesn't have a value. Okay. So how much money we will get? We will get 62 rupees. Why 62 rupees? Because there is a decimal point in the middle. So this 0 doesn't have any value. Sorry, students. So 62 rupees we will get back. See here. While solving problems with the unit rupees paise, when you all have known that unit rupees paise, we are solving the problem meter centimeter. We have used fractions with the two decimal places. We have used the fractions with the two decimal places. That is rupees paise, meter centimeter. Okay, gram kilogram. Liter, milliliter, kilometer, meter. So we have to use with up to three decimal places. Now we have to use up to three decimal places. 1 kg equals to 100 gram. 1 kg equals to 100 gram. This all we have, you maybe have studied in third, fourth standard. Okay. 1 kg equals to 100 gram. It means that if you are having 100 grams, it equals to 1 kg. Half kg means aadha kilo. So half kg means 500 gram. What is the 1000 half? That is 500. So half kg means 500 gram. Now what is quarter? Quarter means 250 gram. Quarter means 250 gram. And two quarter means we have to plus 250 plus 250. That is 500 gram. And third is three quarter. Three quarter equals to 250. See here, I explain you. Quarter, okay? Quarter means 250 gram. This you have understood. Quarter means 250 gram. Quarter kg matlab humko 250 gram. Aap bolte na pao kilo. That is known as a 250 gram. 250 gram. Okay. Quarter kg. Jab hum pao kilo bolte hai, to wo hamara 250 gram hota hai. Jab hum aadha kilo bolte hai, wo hamara 500 gram hota hai. Okay. And we are saying pona kilo. Pona kilo means 750 gram. And how we convert it in English? See here. Quarter kg means 250 gram, and if I will say two quarter means I want two quarter kg, that is 250 plus 250, 0, 10, 5. So two quarter means 500 gram. Two quarter kg means 500 gram. And if I will say three quarter kg equals to 250 plus 250. Wait, huh? Here I will do 250 plus 250. Plus 250. Three times I told na three quarter kg. So I will write three times three for 250. That is 0, 15, 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 2, 6, plus 1 carry, that is 7. So three quarter kg means 750. And if I will say four quarter kg, it is, we are not saying four quarter kg. Four quarter kg hum bolte nahi hai, but for your knowledge, I am saying four quarter kg means 750 plus 250. To wo ho jayenga hamara 1000 gram. It will become 1000 gram. It means 1000 gram equals to 1 kg. So we are not saying that bring quarter kg moong dal, four quarter kg sugar. Why? Because directly we are saying bring 1 kg. Okay, that is 1000 gram. So till three quarter kg we are saying. One quarter kg, that is pao kilo, that is 250 gram. Two quarter kg, that is 500, that in Hindi we are saying aadha kilo, okay? And three quarter kg, that is 750 gram, jisko hum Hindi mein bolte pona kilo, okay? Understood till here? Okay. Now see here. Now here the woman is taking some certain vegetables. Okay, buying some certain vegetables. So here we can see which type of vegetables she is taking and at how many weight. Okay, how many gram or kg. So how the two types they have given, that is gram and kg. Okay, first we will see gram. Potatoes, she has taken 750 gram. Onions, she has taken 100 gram. Cabbage, she has taken 500 gram. And tomatoes, she has taken 250 gram. And if we will convert all them, so how many gram she has taken the all the vegetables? So when you will plus it, you will get 2500 and gram. So let's plus it and see whether the same answer is coming or no. Plus it fast. Okay, so all of you got the same answer. Okay, so what answer you got? You got 2500 grams. What weight you got? That is 2500 grams. The total weight of all the vegetables is 2500 grams. Now see, the grams we have to convert into kg. Now, if there is a above 1000 kg, so it will become 1 kilogram point something something. Okay, yani ki agar 1000 kg ke upar jata hai to 1000 hamara kya ho jata hai, 1 kg ho jata hai, lekin 1000 kg ke andar rehta hai to usko hum gram mein hi convert kar sakte, usko hum kg mein convert nahi kar sakte. Why? Because it doesn't convert into kg, it is not having the weight of 1 kg. It is having the weight of gram only. Okay, so see here, potatoes, they are having 750 gram. So we will write 0.750. Why zero? Because it is not having a 1 kg. So we will write 0.750. Onions is 1000 gram. 1000 equals to 1 kg. 1000 equals to 1 kg. So we will write 1.00. Why 00? Because they are having exactly 1000 gram. Not more than 1000. Exactly 1000 means only 1 kg. So we will write 1.00. I told you after the point, if there is 0, there is no value. So we will take it as 1 kg only. Okay. Cabbage, 500 gram. Now we have to convert it into kg. So kg to ye convert hoinga nahi. So what we will write? We will write 0.500 kg. Why? Zero means there is no kg. 5.500 means there is a gram. Why there is a gram? Because we have put in the decimal fraction. See how the value is changes because of the one decimal point. Because of the one point, the whole number is having a change value. Okay, agar main yahan se 1.00 se agar uska point hata do to yahan pe kitna ho jayega 1000 kg ho jayega, but because